I use a drill to rewind my film because the Gugusse roller motors are simply too slow or too weak for it. Note that I use another longboard wheel to hold the feeding reel, and some paper to add just a hint of friction without burning my fingers. This is the path that the film must use. And trivial change, but important to note, is with the newer software that goes with the newer board version 2.2, the pickup reel will turn the same direction as the feeder reel. So you have to be careful on how you start winding it. Once the film is loaded, start the manual control.py program. It just takes a few seconds to load. I never really explain how the Gugusse roller feed works. At the heart of it, there are those household elastics. Each of the two turntables, the feeder and the pickup, pulls the film, which in turn, pulls on these elastics, thus, maintaining a tension on the film. That tension is important to gain static friction between the film and the longboard wheel. When the longboard wheel turns, it makes film advance in front of the camera. The tension also helps to keep the film flat for a better capture. Too much tension can make scratches on the film when it rubs too hard against the polished bars. Too much tension can also make the turntable's motors to skip steps with a buzzing sound. Before starting to the scanning itself, we need a few things. We need the tension to be already set. You can press Q or Z on the keyboard to respectively make the feeder or the pickup to turn a few degrees. If a turntable turns the wrong direction for you to achieve this, you can press W or X to respectively toggle the direction of the feeder or the pickup. The tension is nominal when the two arms are parallels one to another. The strength of the tension is decided by the characteristics and the number of elastics used. You can only rely on your own experience to choose which elastics and how many of them. Before starting the scan, be sure that each arm is at the left of its own middle position. The capture is a sequence, and I'm going to do my best to describe it to you. The first step is about the two turntables together. The feeder gives some loose, and the pickup picks the loose. Each of the turntables starts turning, and they stops when its assigned arm is detected in its middle position. That's why it's important that before you start the scan, that each arm is at the left of its middle position. Please note that while the turntables are turning, that the film is ideally not moving in front of the camera. I said ideally because it does move a little. That issue occurs mainly out of the difference of tension between the left and the right. That difference in tension is caused by the fact that the pickup reel is empty and the feeder reel is full. The film does not advance at the same speed on both sides. But, after a dozen or so frames, the software calculates the proper speed for each turntable so that the film on both sides advances at the same speed. Only when both arms are detected in their respective middle position that we get to the next step, the film advance. Now the longboard wheel turns and makes the film move in front of the camera. It moves faster, for about 90% of the normal distance of a frame, and then, it slows down for the rest. The slowing down helps to be more precise with the hole detector. When the hole is detected, then the longboard wheel stops. At this point, the software waits a 20th of a second just to let any system vibration to die out. Then the software capture a frame. The cycle repeats itself. Please note that, at this point, the film is pushed-pulled at the same speed from both sides.